Evening, dear students, we'll be studying the next part of module number 2, that is bilinear transformation. Now, what is bilinear transformation? The transformation W is equals to AZ plus B upon CZ plus D, where A, B, C, D are real or complex constants such that AD minus BC is not equals to 0, is called a bilinear transformation. Bilinear transformation is also called as Mobius transformation. Now, what exactly we are going to do in this module is, we know that in a z-plane, coordinates, the points are represented as x, y. Similarly, we are having a w-plane where the coordinates will be represented in the form of u, v. As we know that z is equals to x plus iy. And W is a function of Z, which is represented as U of X, Y plus V of X, Y. Here U and V are the functions of X and Y. Now we'll be given some points for Z. For example, Z is equals to 1, minus I and 1. These are the three points in Z plane which we are going to plot. We are going to check what is the image of this point in W plane, where W will be given something I, 0 and 1. So these mapping done in the Z plane onto the W plane or vice versa is known as bilinear transformation. Now in this part, we are having some note here. Every bilinear transformation maps circles or straight lines in the Z plane into circles or straight lines in the W plane. Means in Z plane, if you are having circle or straight line image, the same image will be seen in the W plane, which is known as bilinear transformation. Next to study, here we have to know what is invariant points. If a point Z maps onto itself, that is W is equals to Z, under the bilinear transformation, then the point is called as invariant point, or also it is said as fixed point of the bilinear transformation. If we have to get this invariant point, we have to substitute here W is equals to Z and solve for the points which will be the invariant points. There are two procedures here. There are a number of procedures actually. In the textbook mentioned, the procedure is to solve the problems on bilinear transformation, they have used W is equals to AZ plus B upon CZ plus D, which is known as a bilinear transformation. In this, we are going to find for A, B, C and D. Here, you will be given three points of Z and corresponding three points of W. We'll substitute in this relation, we will get three simultaneous equations in four unknowns, that is A, B, C, D. Solving for all these four unknowns, substituting back in this W is equals to AZ plus B upon CZ plus D, we get the required bilinear transformation. Now, the method what I am going to adopt is the second, that is the alternate method this is. So, to adopt, I'll be considering a formula, that is W minus W1 upon W1 minus W2 into W2 minus W3 upon W3 minus W is equals to Z minus Z1 upon Z1 minus Z2 into Z2 minus Z3 upon Z3 minus Z. First, I'll consider this formula. Then I'll substitute all the three given points of Z and W. Once I substitute, I will try to multiply the brackets on both sides and convert it into the standard form of the form AW plus B upon CW plus D and EZ plus F upon GZ plus H. Means this side I'll be representing in the form of AW plus B upon CW plus D and this side I'll be representing in the form of EZ plus F upon GZ plus H. I will explain this, what do I mean by this in the problem. Then I'll be taking the matrix form as W is equals to adjoint W into Z. Solving for this, multiplying the first column with Z, that will be our required bilinear transformation. Now here, After getting for this bilinear transformation, we are going to substitute W is equals to Z in the bilinear transformation. We will get the invariant points. Now, I have mentioned here the formula above. Now, how to remember this formula? I'll be giving you a clue. So, first what we have to do is write W, W1, W2, W3. Then put an arrow over here. Then go with the downward arrow, then go upward arrow, and then go with the last arrow, last to first term. So when we are writing for the formula, see there, take W minus W1 in the numerator. Then since the arrow is downward, so it will go in the denominator. So W1 minus W2 will go in the denominator. Next, continuation of the next arrow, it is upward direction, so take it in the numerator. W2 minus W3 upon it is downward, so take W3 minus W. Same way we are doing for this side for Z, and write equals to. This is the formula which I'll be using for the problems. Now, next to start, we'll go with the problems. How to start with the problems now? Find the bilinear transformation which maps the points Z equals to 1, I minus 1 into W equals to I, 0 minus I. To start, first write and take what is Z1, Z2, Z3, W1, W2, W3. Once you write, then take the alternate formula for bilinear transformation. Substitute the given points over here correctly with the signs. If you go wrong in signs, the answer totally gets changed. Now, W I'll be keeping as it is. W1 is I. W1 is I. W2 is 0. Next, W2 is 0. W3 is minus I. So, write minus of minus I. Then, W3 is minus I. W as it is. So, next, Z minus Z1. Z1 is 1. So, Z minus 1. Then, Z1 minus Z2. Z1 is 1, Z2 is I. Next, Z2 is I, Z3 is minus 1. So, minus of minus 1 you have to write. Z3 is minus 1 and this Z will remain as it is. Simplify. W minus I, keep it as it is. Minus of minus it will be plus. 0 plus I is I. I minus 0 is I. Minus I minus W, you write it as it is. Then Z minus 1 as it is. I minus of minus will become plus 1. Then 1 minus I as it is. Minus 1 minus Z, keep it as it is. Now multiplying the brackets. This I should get multiplied to each of the terms. So I into W is IW. I into I is I square. So minus I square. Next, I into minus I, it will become minus I square. I into minus W, it will become minus IW. Next, Z into I is ZI. Z into 1 is Z. Minus I, minus into plus is minus, that is 1. Similarly, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. 1 into minus Z is minus Z. Minus I into minus 1, it is plus I. Minus into minus, it is plus. Z into I is ZI. Further to continue, try to write it in the form of AW plus B divided by, okay. Before I go for, first I'll write what is I square value. I square value is minus 1, so it will become plus 1. Minus I square value is minus 1, that minus and this minus will make it plus 1. Minus IW. Next, ZI plus Z minus I minus 1 upon minus 1 minus Z plus I plus ZI. So, to further continue, try to make it in the form of AW plus B upon CW plus D. So, I have shifted this minus IW here. IW I have written as it is. Here it is. This will become B. This will become D. So, similarly, try to take here Z coefficients common. Here 2 are Z terms. So, take Z common over here. So, when I take Z common, you will get here I plus 1. Next, here minus sign you take common, or you can keep it as it is and write plus of minus I minus 1. Similarly, these are the two terms with Z. So, take Z common between these two, you will get minus 1 plus I. followed with the plus sign, these two terms you write it in the bracket as it is, minus 1 plus I. See to that the expression should not change with this. Like that you have to put it in the bracket. How we have framed this side, same way we have to frame it this side. So once we frame it, we have to write for the matrix, that is W matrix and Z matrix. How to write W matrix and Z matrix? Leave W, write its coefficient, that is I. And another constant coefficient, write it as it is, that is 1. Here the coefficient of W is minus I, so write here minus I, don't write W, and constant term is 1. Similarly, here you write the coefficients of Z here. Coefficient of Z is I plus 1, so write here I plus 1. Then the constant term is minus I minus 1, so write it as it is. Then, here the coefficient of Z is minus 1 plus I. Here the coefficient is minus 1 plus I. So this is what the W matrix and Z matrix. Once we write for this, then we will go with, now consider W is equals to adjoint W into Z. So to start, what do I mean by adjoint? How to write for the adjoint of a matrix? Suppose A matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4. So adjoint of A must be written as, interchange the principal diagonal elements. So this will become 4 and this will become 1. And other two other diagonal elements, whatever we are having, change their signs. This will become minus 2 and minus 3. This is known as the adjoint of a matrix A. Similarly, I have done the same here. Here adjoint of I1 minus 1 I will become, interchange the principal diagonal elements. So this will become 1 and this will be I. Here minus I will become here plus I, and here 1 will become minus 1. And this matrix will remain as it is. Now perform matrix multiplication. Row into column. Row into column. So 1 into I plus 1 right over here, followed with the plus sign, minus 1 into minus 1 plus I over here. This is first row, first column. Leave some gap and write first row, second column, this. Similarly, second row, first column, right over here. Second row, second column, right over here. Simplify the terms. Once we simplify, we'll get 2 minus 2i minus 2 minus 2i. Here, divide the whole matrix by 2. Do not divide by minus 2 because here there is no minus sign. So, only divide by 2. So, when I divide, it will become 1 minus I minus 1 minus I. For this, when we get this W matrix, just for the first column, multiply with Z. So, we will get here Z minus I upon minus Z minus I. Further to simplify, you can take here I common. When I take I common, this will become Z by I, because here you don't have I, so it will become divided by I and minus 1. Here also I am taking I common, this will become minus Z by I minus 1. I will get cancelled. 1 upon I, we know that it is minus I, so this 1 upon I will become minus ZI and minus 1 as it is. This 1 upon I is minus I, so this minus and that minus will make it plus, so ZI minus 1. So if I take the negative sign common, this will become ZI plus 1. Here it will become, this plus ZI will become minus ZI, and here this will become plus 1. So it will become 1 minus ZI. Minus minus will get cancelled. W is equals to 1 plus ZI upon 1 minus ZI. This further, whatever simplification I have done can be avoided or can be neglected. You can keep this much only the answer if you want. Better to simplify for further part. So this is one problem, how to get the bilinear transformation. The next problem we are going to come is, find the bilinear transformation which maps Z is equals to infinity I 0 into W is equals to minus 1 minus I 1. Also find the fixed points of the transformation. Now fixed point means invariant point. Okay. So now this is Z1 is equals to infinity, Z2 is equals to I, Z3 is equals to 0. W1 is equals to minus 1, W2 is equals to minus I, W3 is equals to 1. Write and take. Now to start, consider the formula. I have told you how to remember this formula. Now here if you see the point, Z1 has come infinity. Now whenever you get an infinity point, don't directly go to substitute the points first. Very first step is, what we have to do is, remove Z1 common in which bracket it is present. So here it is Z1 present, so take Z1 common. So when I take Z1 common, this will become Z upon Z1 minus 1. Similarly, take Z1 common over here, it will become 1 minus Z2 upon Z1. So this is what I have done. I have cancelled the Z1, so I will remain with this formula. Now substitute the points. When I substitute the points, here Z1 is infinity, so here I have got Z upon infinity minus 1. Similarly, here it will become I upon infinity. Now we know that anything divided by infinity is always 0. So Z by infinity is 0, I by infinity is also 0. So this terms will become 0. After getting for this, you will get this terms which are in the bracket form. Multiply the brackets in the numerator and in the denominator. This side simplified form is I by Z. When I multiply, now try to make this form as AW plus B, CW plus D. Here at least there is no such form. It is understood that this will become EZ plus F. EZ means, now here there is no Z term, so I have written 0Z. And here only I term is there, so this will become F. Next here, GZ means, now here Z is only there, so I have written here GZ plus H. Now here there is no H, means I have taken it as 0. Here, W terms are there, so take W terms in the bracket, plus followed with the other two terms must be written in the bracket. Similarly, here there is W term, so take W term common, so I will get 1 minus I. This is plus, and the remaining two terms must be written in the bracket with the plus sign in the middle. Now write for the matrix of W and Z. So minus I minus 1 right over here, minus I minus 1 right over here, 1 minus I right over here, minus 1 plus I right over here. Here coefficient of Z is 0, so write here 0, this I as it is, 1, and this is 0. Once we finish writing this matrix, then we will take the formula, that is, consider W is equals to adjoint W into Z. Now to start, write for the W matrix here, write for the Z matrix. Now, adjoint means interchanging the principal diagonal elements and interchanging the signs of the other diagonal element. Now, this will come over here, this will come over here. This 1 minus I will become now minus 1 plus I. This minus I minus 1 will become plus I plus 1. Next, solving for the matrix, row into column. When I solve it, I will get the bilinear transformation in this form, where I have to multiply the first column with Z. So once I multiply with Z, I see that if I take the negative sign common, I will get here I plus 1, here also I will get I plus 1. If I take the negative sign common, or both the terms are same, so we can take that common, I am remained with Z minus 1 upon minus Z minus 1. So if you see here, we can take minus sign common such that I will get Z minus 1 upon Z plus 1. This negative sign, when it comes above, this will become minus Z and this will become plus 1. So 1 minus Z upon Z plus 1. So this is known as the bilinear transformation. Now next to go with, they have asked us to find for the fixed point. So to find for the fixed point, just substitute here W as Z in this transformation, we will get this as Z is equals to 1 minus Z upon 1 plus Z. Cross multiply, take this denominator this side. So Z into 1 plus Z is equals to 1 minus Z. Solving for the brackets, you will get a quadratic equation, which we can solve it by taking AX square plus BX plus C is equals to 0, which can be solved by the formula minus B plus or minus root of B square minus 4AC upon 2A. Substitute as per comparing A is 1, B is 2, C is minus 1, and X is nothing but our Z. This quadratic equation is in terms of Z, so X is Z. Substituting, simplifying, here plus or minus is there, so this becomes minus 1 plus root 2, z is equals to minus 1 minus root 2. These are known as invariant points, which are also called as fixed points. So like this, whenever you get infinity, here w3 is infinity, so you have to take the w3 common and then substitute the points. So this is known as the bilinear transformation. For any doubts, you can call me or feel free to WhatsApp the message. Thank you.